This episode is brought to you by Fly UAV New Zealand and FPV Australia.
We've spoken about drones before, but the subject goes deeper. There's been a lot of changes, and one of them is that CASA no longer require you to be licensed to fly a sub 2 kilo drone. This means a drone that weighs less than 2 kilos for commercial purposes. But unless you're working on a farm, this isn't going to fly. We recently sat down with Richard from Fly UAV New Zealand and FPV Australia to learn a little bit more about this emerging technology and the regulations surrounding it. Enjoy.
Pilot is somebody who takes the industry seriously. He doesn't treat his aircraft as a toy. It is specifically that. It is an aircraft. It is no different in the aviation sense from the Boeing 737 that you travel internationally on. It is no different from the rescue helicopter or even, you know, the light sports aircraft. The other things that are really important are that people who are taking this seriously have good communication. They're not worried about asking for help when they need it. Everybody needs help at some stage, and it's really important that RPAS operators can ask other industry professionals or other operators themselves for help and guidance. You can go out and buy your drone that is under 2 kilograms, and you can start operating commercially. However, CASA have some quite strict guidelines, and they are very similar to what the original Part 101 guidelines were, and that is you are not allowed to fly above 400 feet. You're not allowed to fly at night. You're not allowed to fly within 30 meters of people, and that is any people. So that is people that are in their houses, in buildings, walking along the street, the whole nine yards. You're also not allowed to fly over populous areas. Now, populous areas is urban environments, such as down at the local coffee shop, the local sports field. It's suburban environments, so flying around at home even can be considered illegal, and it's certainly not flying at sport events. You need to do a training course, which is through a CASA-certified organisation, such as FPV Australia, which the LMI group have used, and you need to have a CASA-approved operating certificate. Now, the licence is all about aviation training, specific to drones, so that you're not learning or you're not being taught anything that's not specific to drones, but you're learning about threat and error management, you're learning about yourselves, the risks of going flying, you're learning about air law legislation, you're learning about charts, and you're getting a broad overview of the little industry that we have, the emerging industry that we have. You're also trained on machines. So it's about a little bit more than manufacturer's training. It's about going out, learning the do's and don'ts of your machine, learning the safety procedures involved, your pre-flights, your post-flights, how to actually handle the machine, and also what to do when things go wrong. And things will eventually go wrong. And the more conditional training that you have, that upfront training at the beginning, the better the outcome is going to be down the track when things go wrong. From the operator certificate point of view, what you are essentially doing is you're taking the RPAS, Remotely Piloted Aircraft System, or as some people know them, drone rules, and you're putting them into a set of health and safety documents for aviation. Those are the ways that you are going to work, and you agree with CASA, you are going to keep yourself safe, the general public safe, and the whole environment itself safe. You've got to look at our training course as a hat and a bunch of feathers, and you've now got to take the next step and get yourself ready to work in industry. And that is a mixture of continuing to practice, that is a mixture of getting your first job or your first set of jobs, and learning along the way. The costs, of course, do develop as you go. You have more expensive aircraft, more expensive equipment, more safety equipment. You have continuation training. FPV Australia runs other courses, more advanced training, where you can refine your skills. The other part that is really good is operators who have common sense. It's really, really important that if you have that gut feeling that what you're doing is not right, it's probably not. When I first got my commercial pilot's license, the flight testing officer said to me, "Richard, if you have doubt, there is no doubt." And that is something that I've lived by for about the last 15 years. If I'm flying the RPAS around, if I'm in an environment where I'm starting to think, I'm not really that comfortable, that is a really good opportunity just to pull back a little bit. It's not stop and go home. Just pull back just that notch and say, right, let's reassess this situation. And the number of times that it's actually got me out of trouble or it stopped me from getting into trouble, I couldn't count on my fingers. We have some large machines that are becoming very accessible on the secondhand market that are ex-cinema quality type machines, which are not as easy to fly as, say, the DJI products, which are very hands-on, very consumer level. It's also important to understand that we have another emerging industry that's been born out of the mini quad racing. As a keen mini quad pilot, our machines can do upwards of 60, 70, 80, 90, even 100 kilometers an hour. And they are deadly machines. They are in and out in a split second. And the average person at the park who's walking their dog doesn't know it's there until it's already flown past them. And it can be frightening. I think we need to be so aware that whether it's a small machine or whether it's a big machine, it's not a toy. I think one thing that we all need to be very aware of is that even if we're certified in our own countries to fly, that when we go on holiday, we travel internationally, we go somewhere else for work, that another country may have some very specific guidelines. And when you do travel internationally, we're not saying don't take your drone with you, don't go flying with your drone. I mean, you can get some incredible footage of your holiday or of the destination, but just take a moment to look up the local regulations. So, for example, if you're traveling to New Zealand, please check out the New Zealand CAA's website, www.caa.govt.nz, or ring a local operator. And operators are easy enough to find in any country. Just use Google. The piece of advice that I'd give to people is that we are pioneers and early adopters of our industry, and that if we do not behave like good ambassadors, this industry could evaporate very, very quickly. Other facets of aviation do have a keen interest on what happens with RPAS. If we don't treat it with respect, it won't treat us with respect either.
If you want to learn a little bit more about Fly UAV New Zealand or FPV Australia, there'll be a link in the description. Click here for another video we did, give us a thumbs up if you found this helpful, comment with more stuff you want to know about, and for more demystified insurance jargon, click that subscribe button.